Well, hello everyone. My name is Jairaj and welcome to Spring Boot tutorial series by JR Academy. So this is tutorial 2, tools for development, and in this tutorial we're gonna look into some of the tools that we will require for this tutorial series. So let's get started. First thing we will require for this tutorial series is Java versions, and there are so many versions as I mentioned in previous tutorial, but we will use Java version 8 or Java 1.8. Both are basically same, but it is just a difference of naming convention. So let's see how we can download and install that. Before installing JDK in your system, just open your terminal or command prompt and check you already have JDK installed or not. So just type fire a command such as java hyphen version, and it will show you the details. So in my case I already have Java 1.8 installed, but if in your case it is not installed, then it will show errors such as Java command not found. And if you have another version installed, then it will show that version. But for this tutorial series we need to install Java 1.8. so to install Java JDK 8, just go to your browser and search for JDK 8 download, and it will take you to the link from the Oracle, and just click that link and it will give you the download prompt immediately. Just go there and select your operating system or accept the license, and it will download the package in your system. Once you download, just double click on it and it will install it pretty. It is not that difficult process. After installation, just open your console again, your command prompt again, and type the same command java hyphen version here, and you will see it is installed or not. Another thing we will require is IDE. IDE is an integrated development environment, which is a software which will help you to code, and there are so many IDEs out there, but I'm gonna use Eclipse, and you can use any one of them, whichever you are comfortable with. So let's see how we can download Eclipse and install. To install Eclipse, just go to your browser and type like Eclipse download, and it will show you the link, and go here like Eclipse IDE for Java developer and download the installer first. Once you download the installer from here and you double click on it, it will open this prompt. So here you need to choose Eclipse IDE for Java developers or enterprise developers and just install. So here it will ask you for the Java VM's path. So in your system, once you install your Java, it will be here somewhere. So in your program file, there is a folder named Java and give a path to JRE or JDK, and the install. It will install without any trouble after this. And another thing we will require is some developer tools. So most of the modern browsers will have developer tools inbuilt, so you don't need to worry about Chrome developer tools. And another tool is a Postman. So what is Postman and what we can do with this Postman, we will look later, but for now just download and install, and we will go in deep with these old tools. To install Postman, just go to your browser and type like search for Postman download, and it will go take you to the link here, download Postman app. So actually in the case of Postman, you can install Chrome extensions also, but I would recommend it to go with the app. So if you install Postman plugin, Chrome plugin, then you will see your Postman here, such as this ad blocker thing. And if you install the Postman app, it will separately open as a software. So just go here and download, and it is a very simple process to install it. And once you install it, will open such as this one. So what is Postman and how we can use it, we will see in the future. So that's all for now in this tutorial, and see you in next tutorial. Till then, like, subscribe and keep learning. Thank you very much.